Our recipe is soft idli, or you can call it as khushbu idli or mallige idli. This is a very good recipe and it's very very soft idli. Here have taken 4 cups of rice. This is idli rice. See, you can see this is called idli rice. Here I have taken in this cup, whichever cup you take, in that same measurement you have to take udad dal. This is udad dal. Here I have taken 1 cup of udad dal in the same cup which I have taken for rice. The same cup here I used for measuring udad dal as well. And this is sago seed, or you can call it as sabudana. This one. This here I have taken the same cup, half cup of sago seed or sabudana, and 1 teaspoon of fenugreek. I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of fenugreek to this udad dal, and we have to wash it well and soak it in the water. Cook it for 6 hours. See friends, it's been a 6 hours, our udad dal and fenugreek soaked well. Now it's time to grind it like a smooth batter. Here I'm going to add little by little water and grind it like a smooth batter. Friends, here I'm grinding, adding little by little water as a smooth batter. I'll show you the consistency after grinding. See friends, our udad dal batter is ready. See, it's very smooth paste. The consistency should be like this, not so watery, but it has to grind so soft and very nice paste, because we are making soft idli, mallige idli. Friends, now udad dal batter is ready. In the same mixer jar, I'm gonna add rice and sago seed which we have soaked it. Now I'm gonna add together and blend it like a smooth batter. This is the soaked rice. I'm gonna add batch by batch. Don't add too much in at a time. So I'm gonna add little by little along with this sago seed. Add little bit of water and make a smooth batter. Make a batter now, and I'll show you the consistency as well once I grind it. Friends, rice is also become smooth batter. See, I've grinded like a smooth batter, and I'll show you the consistency. Consistency. See friends, now we have to mix it well. Our batter is ready, because first I grinded udad dal, so now I'm mixing. We have to give a nice mix here. See, that too with your hands only you have to do this. See friends, give a very nice mix. If you want, you can add salt also here, and you should close tightly and keep it for fermentation. And morning you have to make idli. Minimum 6 to 7 hours you have to keep the batter for the fermentation. In winter you need so more time for the fermentation. Summer it will ferment so fast because of the heat. See friends, see the consistency should be like this, not so watery, because we are making a idli, so consistency should be like this. Our batter is fully fermented. See, it's very soft. Now no need to mix it. First take one idli mold and grease some oil into this. Like this you have to grease all the molds, so then our idli will not stick to the mold. This idli will become very very soft. And again you should not mix the batter. Now let's start pouring our batter to the mold. And when you're pouring, no need to press hard. Just take one scoop and pour it like this. Everything is ready. Now we are gonna steam boil for 15 minutes. It is boiling. we need to keep this in the middle of the idli stand. Should be middle, and we need to cover the idli cooker. Let it steam for 15 minutes. See friends, now our idli is cooked well. Now I'm gonna switch off the flame and open the lid. See friends, idli. Now I'll show you how soft it is. I'll take it out and let it cool for 5 minutes, or else our idli will break. It has to cool down for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I'm gonna remove idlis from the idli mold. You have to dip spoon in the water and take it like this. See here, it's not sticking to the mold. It's coming very easily. Like that, you have to take one by one and keep it in a hot bag. And this idli you have to eat along with sambar. I'm going to show you how to make idli sambar, hotel style idli sambar as well. See how soft idli is. It's like a flower. See, you can see the fluffiness. It's very soft. This is called mallige idli or soft idli. See, very soft. Here I'm gonna show you how to make idli sambar. It's purely hotel style. It's a South Indian idli sambar. Here are all the ingredients. Have taken 2 tomatoes cut into slices. Here 1 bowl of beetroot cut into small pieces. And this is capsicum cut into small pieces. Here I have taken chopped onions. 2 onions I have taken because we need to add it for grinding as well as for making sambar also. Here I have taken 1 bowl of finely chopped cabbage, and this is 1 bowl of carrot cut into small pieces like this, and few garlic cloves and curry leaves. 1 small lemon size tamarind. Soak it in the hot water. We need to extract the juice from the here tamarind. 1 bowl of tuar dal, washed it, and have taken 3 vijal and mashed it. Here is the masala ingredient. Here I have taken 1 teaspoon of chana dal, 1 teaspoon of urad dal, 4 to 5 red chili, dry red chili. You can take according to your taste. And some pieces of dry coconut, 1/4 teaspoon of fenugreek, 4 to 5 peppercorns, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin, and 1/2 teaspoon of coriander seed. We need to dry roast all the ingredients. Let's make it friends. Pan on the stove and add all our dried ingredients. No need to add any oil to this. Just dry roast till the aroma comes out. Now transfer this dry roasted masala mixer jar and add all the dry roasted ingredients to this. Have added all the dry roast ingredient. Now we need to dry roast 1 tomato and 1 onion, sliced onion, and the same what you dry roast, you need to add this to the mixer jar, the same mixer jar, and grind it to a smooth paste. I'll show you. The same pan, I have added 1 onion, sliced onion, roughly chopped onion, and 1 roughly chopped tomato into this. We need to saute for 5 minutes till it turns golden brown. Here I have added 4 garlic cloves and few curry leaves to this. Let's dry roast all the ingredients and add it in the same mixture jar and grind it to a smooth paste. No need to add any water to this. I'll show you. See friends, here it's turned golden brown. Now switch off the flame and let it cool down, and we'll make a smooth paste along with the dry ingredient. In this only we need to add this and make a smooth paste. Here I have made a smooth paste. I blended like a smooth paste. I did not add much water. If you feel that dry ingredients are very dry, you can add little by little water, but don't make the paste very thin, because we are adding here tomato and onion, so no need to add much water. If you feel that it's dry, you can add little by little water to make a smooth paste like this. Now it's time to make a sambar. Let's keep one vessel on the stove and switch on the flame. Now it's time to add little oil to the vessel. Here I'm adding little oil. Let the flame be in medium. Now add some asafoetida. Now it's time to add the remaining finely chopped onion to this. Saute for few seconds. Saute for few seconds. Now it's time to add chopped tomato to this. Now it's time to add our veggie one by one. Now I'm gonna add all the veggies. Now I'm adding chopped beetroot to this. Just give a quick mix. Now I'm gonna add capsicum to this. Just give a quick mix. Like this, add one by one veggies. Now I'm gonna add chopped carrots to this. Carrot. I added carrot to this. Now it's time to add our last cabbage. Here I'm adding cabbage. Here I have added cabbage and all the veggies one by one I have added. And it's time to add some salt. I never add salt while boiling our tuvar dal, so it's time to add salt here according to your taste. I've added salt and give a quick mix. Now it's time to add tamarind juice to this, which you have extracted from the tamarind I've soaked earlier. Now give a quick mix and close the lid and cover it and cook it for 5 minutes. Let the veggie cook in this tamarind water for 5 minutes. Here it started boiling. Let it boil for 5 minutes. Here veggies are boiling in the tamarind water. Now it's time to add our blended masala to this. No need to add any water here. First, let me add this blended masala to this. Let's mix it well and cook it for 5 minutes. No need to add any water here. Let the masala cook nicely. Here our masala cooked well. You can see this. Now it's time to add boiled mashed tuvar dal to this. And give a nice mix. And add water according to the thickness of the sambar. See friends, here I have added water. You can see the paste over here. You can check it here. Salt, spices, everything. And if you want, you can add little jaggery also. But here I am not adding any jaggery, because my husband likes spicy version. So I am not adding any jaggery. And what we added, carrot and beetroot, that already leaves some sweetness to the sambar. So no need to add any extra sweet. If you feel that it's more spicy, you can add it according to your taste. Let it boil. We'll cover and boil it. Let it boil. So I'm gonna cover this and cook for 10 to 15 minutes until veggies are well cooked. See friends, here our sambar is boiling and almost all the veggies are well cooked. Nice aroma is also coming out. Now it's time to turn off the flame. Friends, today's our one more recipe is chutney. This is coconut and peanut chutney. It will go very well with idli dosa. So first we need to add some coconut, fresh coconut, scraped or sliced one, to the mixer jar. And this is peanut or groundnut, you can call it as groundnut as well. Roasted groundnut and peel out the skin. This also I'm gonna add it here. And this is dry red chili. This also you need to roast it, dry roast it. Here I'm gonna add chili into this and some garlic cloves, 4 to 5 garlic cloves. If you don't like garlic, you can skip also. And some tamarind to this. I soaked it in the water. Tamarind to this. And add some salt and make a smooth paste.
Can you make me the
cilantro or coriander to this and add some water and make a fine paste. Add little by little water while grinding and make a smooth paste. Again cover it and blend it. See friends, now it's time to take a idli. You have to dip one spoon in the water and take one by one. See friends, our idli has become very soft, like a spongy. You can see here. See? Very soft idli. See friends, our coconut and peanut chutney is ready. Now I'm gonna serve to my family idli, chutney and sambar. This is our Friday's weekend breakfast. Friends, now my husband and my son is gonna taste and let you know the taste of our weekend South Indian breakfast. Sambar, chutney, idli. I didn't make vada. How is it? It's hot?
Yes.
Very nice.
Is it?
Super. Lovely. Mallige idli.
Yes.
We call it as mallige idli in our South India.
Yeah.
This is very, very nice. Very
so
nice.
Yummy, friends.
So yummy.
So yummy.
My son is also eating.
You have to soak idli in the sambar for 1 or 2 seconds and then take it out and then dip it in the chutney and then put it in your mouth.
Mm-hmm. You're also doing the same, Pranav?
Yes.
Thank you.
Very nice. Thank you, Mom.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching our video. If you like, please subscribe our channel and click the bell icon for more recipes. Don't forget to click the like button, friends. Bye, friends. Have a great day. Bye.